Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be tie-dyeing. It's a really big trend to tie-dye like white clothes kind of subtly. So we are working on making our dyes right now. So here are all the products we are going to be tie-dyeing. So we have this little Calvin Klein sports bra, a cute little cropped tank top, a big white oversized hoodie. My sister has all of those products as well, and then she also is doing this little pair of white shorts and just a normal white t-shirt for her boyfriend. Things you will need: tie-dye and bowls or squirt bottles and rubber bands and rubber gloves and whatever the instructions on your tie-dye say to use. Get those products as well. Okay, so basically what we're doing is duct taping where it says Calvin Klein because we don't want that part to be dyed. We just want like the white of the bra to be dyed. I'm currently duct taping my bra. Okay, so we're gonna start with the tank top. I think for the top, I'm gonna do teal.
I'm gonna do pink.
Okay, pink and teal for our tank tops. We're gonna scrunch them right now.
To like a sushi, I call it the sushi method.
It's a really creative moment.
So I like folded it and then rolled it up and then I rolled it up where the duct tape side was.
Duct tape.
So we'll see how it turns out.
So cool. Here's what I've got going on so far. Here is my sports bra. Here is my tank top. Here's my little scrunchie. It's so little, look, it's like the size of that. So I'm thinking I'm gonna do blue for this, the tank top. I don't really care about what the scrunchie is. I'll probably do pink for a scrunchie. And then for my bra, maybe I'll do purple. And then for my sweatshirt, I'm gonna do blue and orange because I feel like that might be sick. The blue and orange we have are like contrast colors. So that, and like those are my favorite colors, so. Perfect. Okay, so we're filling up the buckets with water right now, and then we're gonna put the boiling water in with them so that we get like a medium temperature. And then we're gonna put this dye in there. And I don't know what we're supposed to do for this dye, do you know?
We're gonna do the same thing, but we're
same
not
thing
gonna
for
use
this
salt.
Dye. But we're not using salt for this one because this is already a liquid, and these are like salt grain form, I guess.
Okay, I don't know if that's why.
We're putting a half cup of salt into like a little bit of water. Just this is the cold water right now, or like the hose water. So what we're doing, here's the bucket of the cold water and salt mixture. And now I'm gonna pop in half of this because we're just doing half because we don't have a lot of fabric we're gonna be doing. So we're just gonna do half, and this is the pink color. Here comes, oh my God, please do not burn me. I'm gonna put half of this in there. So here is the pink. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put the orange in. Orange is my favorite color. Welcome to my house. Here's the orange color we're doing. Tangerine Mandarina. So this one is like dark, dark red. This is the orange and that's the pink. And then the last one we have to do is the purple. I'm gonna just pop the purple in. I should have put on gloves, but it's fine, right? That is our purple. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my little squanchie into the pink. So here's the pink. Do I just drop it in?
Yeah, because you want it to be all pink, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, ready? Bye-bye. There it goes. Putting my tank top into the blue. Ah! I'm gonna take these tongs right here and dip this in here like that. That's so cute. Love that purple. Now I'm gonna grab the purple end and put the white into the pink. Currently we have my tank top, Cassie's bra, and my bra over here is like ombre kind of. And Cassie's now working on like tying up her sweatshirt. And I'm about to start that. And so what we're doing is putting the blue dye into the funnel, into this like spray bottle. so that I can spray it instead of dip it, because I want to make multi-colors. Back. I had dance, so I had to go do that for a sec, but now here I am. Here's my final sweatshirt wrap. So I'm gonna spray this with blue first and then with orange. I'm crawling around, searching for higher ground. Can't see in front of me. Now we've got orange in here that I'm gonna go in with. Here's my final sprayed dyed sweatshirt. I'm really excited to see how it ends up looking, because right now it looks kind of interesting. But yeah, it's dope. Now we're back, and here are like the things kind of drying. Some of them were washing already, but ooh, that's my sports bra. This is Cassidy's sports bra. She just did orange. Here's Cassidy's tank top. My scrunchie, and then it looks like the t-shirt that Cassidy made is right here. Basically, we all realized that we have a ton of dye left, even though we used only like half of the box. Basically, what we're gonna go do is find some more like t-shirts of ours that we can dye. Here's my room, look at my room. But I'm gonna look through my bench here. This is where I keep all my t-shirts because I'm cool and quirky like that. And my bench is storage. So, let's see what we've got going on. This could be dope to tie-dye. Yeah? Okay, option. I could tie-dye this. My Adidas shirt. Let's do that. That's dope. This is turning into Kerrigan just looking through her drawers, finding what she doesn't wear and tie-dyeing it so she can wear it. Like upcycling. Work. I'll see you outside. Okay, I'll see you guys outside because my stairs are so loud because my house is so old. So for this one, I'm just doing like a long moment, like a jasmine ponytail. I don't really know how it's gonna look. Hopefully it looks cool. I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm not the camp counselor that my mother is. Here's what's going on in my tub right now. Shanti's making her own shirt. Now I'm gonna do this one. Okay, here's this final one. So I accordion flipped it like I showed you, and then I just put rubber bands vertically, and then I rolled in the sides to just make it a little more compact so I can fit it into the bucket. So let's put this in purple. Ooh, that's cool. Round her in there. Now that I've like rubber banded everything in, put it in the dyes for the most part, I think, yeah, I did everything. We just have to wash. We're washing like the first round of stuff, and then we're gonna go take out the stuff that's in the dye right now in like 20-30 minutes, and then we'll wash that and put like the safe color stay stuff on it. That's what my mom's been doing down in the basement, and then we'll be good to go. And then we get to try it on and see if it's all cute. Okay, everyone, the second round is done, I believe. So we're gonna take it out and see what's going on. This is the first round of products. So let's see. This looks like my tank top.
Have you heard of the
tank? That's really cute. I like that.
This is so cute, isn't it? I love it. It looks like something you would get off of like Princess Polly almost. Okay, here is Cassidy's shirt she made for her boyfriend. It has like the West Virginia logo on it, kinda. It's very veined. I don't know if you can see that. But yeah, and then here's one my mom made for herself. Then here's Cassidy's tank top. And we've got other things getting taken out right now. Then what else do we got going on? Here's my sports bra. It wasn't supposed to be blue, but somehow it got blue on it. And then Cassidy's sports bra was supposed to be just orange, but again, it somehow got blue on it. Here is the Polo Ralph Lauren one. I really like this one. I don't know why, I just feel like it's really cute because mainly it's oversized, which is dope.
Make sure you get a snack, because this is a long process. I'm having some sweet potato bites. They're really good. Very scrumptious.
Okay, time to unravel my sweatshirt. Here's the sweatshirt.
So, just looks like that, pretty much. I'll show you it, obviously, when we wash everything. We'll have, like, a little runway show, so.
We're gonna clean up now, and then I will show you guys the final products in 3, 2, 1.
So this is the tank top I made. I didn't think it was gonna be all blue, but I like it, so it's like all good. But like it's cool that it's like darker blue in certain spots, so I really like this. I think this might be one of like the best things I made. Next is this Adidas top I dyed like last minute. I think the back is actually cooler than the front on this one, but it's still cool all the way around. It's kind of, I went for like an ombre like striped look. It's interesting. I don't know if I love it. Oh, by the way, here's my scrunchie I did. It was supposed to be pink, but now it's blue, so what are you gonna do? Oh well, it's cute though. Work. This one is my Polo Ralph Lauren one that I did. I love this one. I think the purple with the blue is really cool, and also like the stripes are dope because they're like dark and then lighter. So yeah, so this was actually supposed to be purple and pink, but it also ended up blue. I think my mom accidentally mixed some blue stuff with the purple and pink stuff, like popsicle kind of vibe. I like how it's like one side's like that and then like there's just like faded purple throughout it. Here's the tank top my sister made. I think this was supposed to be pink as well, but it's like a little more like, it has like a faint blue tint to it, but it's like purpley and pink splotches. Okay, and here's my sweatshirt. I love how this one turned out. Definitely my favorite. I did blue and orange and it held its color really well. I think it's just super sick. The hood, it's so sick. Yeah, that is so sick. So I literally love every single thing I made. They're all so cute and turned out kind of like really like what I was going for, which is kind of hard in tie-dye sometimes because you never know what's like gonna happen really. So I'm really glad that they turned out super cute. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, remember to give me a big thumbs up. And if you wanna see more videos from me, subscribe down below and leave me a comment telling me what your favorite item I made was. And if you guys make your own tie-dye stuff, make sure to tag me at carefree. I'll be right here. It's also in the description below. So I'll see you guys later and have a fantabulous day. That's, oh, it's Cinco de Mayo. Happy Cinco de Mayo. I don't know if I'm gonna be posting this on Cinco de Mayo, but happy Cinco de Mayo, everybody. Okay, goodbye.